Well, good evening and welcome to our Christmas Eve Nativity service. About this time on Christmas Eve, usually the church is full of children dressed up as their favourite Nativity character, and occasionally with some extra superheroes or animals thrown in for good measure. It's such a joyful occasion with grandparents, parents, carers, friends and family all coming together on this last moment of gathering before the celebrations of Christmas morning. Of course, none of that is possible this year, and so we are offering this service online, retelling the familiar story in these most unfamiliar circumstances. Recognising that for many of us alone this year, in light of the new restrictions that were introduced on Saturday, the heartbreaking absence of friends and family that means so much at this time of year. In the midst of these very difficult times, we still seek to find comfort and joy in the Christmas story. The story of a baby born as a gift to this world. A baby who will be called Emmanuel, God with us, as God brings himself into this world to share in our joys and our sorrows, as the carols remind us. So I pray that this evening, the night before Christmas, as we watch this service together, we will find comfort in the togetherness of knowing that nothing can separate us from the love of God shown to us in Christ Jesus. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, on this difficult day, in this difficult time, as we look forward to tomorrow, the birth of your Son, knowing that for many of us, the separation from loved ones will bring much pain and sadness, we pray that the good news of your coming, the good news of the light shining in the darkness, which the darkness may not overcome, might bring us comfort and joy. Be with us, we pray, as we look to celebrate your coming. In Jesus' name, amen. This afternoon, we are going to hear the traditional Nativity story read to us from scripture and in poetry. The cast of the Nativity has, I'm afraid, had to be drawn largely from the vicarage household because of the new isolation rules, but I'm grateful to Victoria, Pippa, Beth and Rachel for joining us in the vicarage garden to help with that recording. We're very grateful to the authors of the script too for giving us permission to use it. We're going to pray together and we're going to light a candle to remind us of that light that shines. First of all, we're going to have our first carol.
Christmas is coming, a great time of year. Presents, food, tinsel, and lots of good cheer. Those things are nice, but they're not the real reason that we always celebrate this special season. The point is that this is when God became man. The first ever Christmas was part of that plan.
I'll start the story. Come on, gather round. I'm Mary from Nazareth. That's my hometown. God's angel, Gabriel, came to meet me there. He startled me, gave me a terrible scare. The message he gave me didn't seem true. Shocking it was what he asked me to do.
God sent the angel Gabriel to a town in Galilee named Nazareth. He had a message for a young woman, promised in marriage to a man named Joseph, who was a descendant of King David. Her name was Mary. The angel came to her and said, "Peace be with you. The Lord is with you and has greatly blessed you." Mary was deeply troubled by the angel's message, and she wondered what his words meant. The angel said to her, "Don't be afraid, Mary. God has been gracious to you. You will become pregnant and give birth to a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High God. The Lord God will make him a king, as his ancestor David was. And he will be the king of the descendants of Jacob forever. His kingdom will never end."
It's good news I'm bringing. Do not be afraid. God's coming to earth. His plans are all made. The human race needs him, and he'll save you all. He'll come as a baby, helpless and small. And Mary, you are the Lord's chosen one. He wants you as mum for his only son.
If it's God's will, let it be as you've said. Though people will talk, as I'm not yet wed. Joseph's a good man. He'll care for the child. I hope that in time, we'll be reconciled. Yes, I accept the task that's for me. I will love and care for my unborn baby.
While Joseph was thinking about all Mary had told him, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, descendant of David, do not be afraid to take Mary to be your wife, for it is by the Holy Spirit that she has conceived. She will have a son, and you will name him Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins."
"Joseph, I'm here now to tell you God's will. Don't worry, Mary is true to you still. She is so special. She's God's chosen one. The child that she's carrying is God's own son. What she must do won't be easy, I fear. She'll need your love and protection. That's clear."
At that time, Emperor Augustus ordered a census to be taken throughout the Roman Empire. When this first census took place, Quirinius was the governor of Syria. Everyone then went to register himself, each to his own hometown.
"I am a herald, so listen to me. I'm here to give you a royal decree. The king wants to count you. It would be good to check that you're paying your tax as you should. But instead of counting you all where you are, go back to where you're from. I don't care how far."
"Now Mary's my wife. The time soon draws near for her to give birth. Yet sadly, I fear that Bethlehem town is where we need to go. My people are from there. We cannot say no. We have to obey the royal decree to be counted there with my family."
Joseph went from the town of Nazareth in the Galilee to the town of Bethlehem in Judah, the birthplace of King David. Joseph went there because he was a descendant of David. He went to register with Mary, who was promised in marriage to him. She was pregnant, and while they were in Bethlehem, the time came for her to have a baby. she gave birth to her first son, wrapped in clothes, and laid him in a manger. There was no room for them to stay in the inn.
Welcome to Bethlehem. Have you a booking? Oh dear, then I'm sorry. You haven't a look in. All of my rooms are fully booked out. That's true for everywhere here and about. My stable is free for you, I suppose. It's warm, although reasonably hard on the nose.
No rooms to be found in Bethlehem town. So, in a stable, we set ourselves down. Sometimes God's plans just don't seem to make sense. Something is happening. I'm feeling quite tense. The world will be changed before it gets light. This baby is coming now, right here, tonight.
There were some shepherds in that part of the country who were spending the night in the fields taking care of the flocks. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone over them. They were terribly afraid. The angel said to them, "Don't be afraid. I'm here with good news for you, which will bring great joy to all the people. This very day in David's town, your Saviour was born, Christ the Lord. And this is what will prove it to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger."
Good news! The best news I will ever bring! God has been born. You must welcome your king. He will fulfil the promise of old. You shepherds are lucky, first to be told. Go, find a baby born in a stable. Run now to greet him, as fast as you're able.
What kind of news is this? What can it mean? What kind of God would want us on the scene? Honestly, I know we smell like our sheep. We're a bit dirty, don't get enough sleep. But it must be true that God loves us still. Let's hurry together and go down the hill.
When the angels went away from them back into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and saw the baby lying in a manger.
Well, here we are now, my beautiful boy. How can one so small bring us so much joy? Your mother and I, we swear we will do whatever it takes to look after you. You're special in many ways, my darling one. Here in my arms, I am holding God's son.
Knocking again? I've just got back to sleep. There's been crying and trumpets, and now there's some sheep. I've been disturbed every time I lie down. It's worse than having a baby around. Looking for Mary? Well, follow the track. She's out in the stable, just round the back.
Excuse me, is there a baby in here? We've come to adore him. Aw, isn't he dear? The angels sent us, we answered their call. They told us this child is Lord of us all. And now that I've seen him, that really seems right. And all of my life, I'll remember this night.
Jesus was born in the town of Bethlehem in Judea during the time when Herod was king. Soon afterwards, some men who studied the stars came from the east to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the baby born to be king of the Jews? We saw this star when it came up in the east, and we have come to worship him."
I am a wise man. Some call me King Caspar. But one comes soon, who is my true master. All of my life, I've been longing to see this king, who'll be much more mighty than me. He'll be born far from here, but one thing I know, when the time comes, I'll be ready to go.
I'm Melchior. I also long for the prince. I spent years and years looking for hints, scanning the sky for anything weird. Suddenly now our guide has appeared. Together with Caspar and Balthazar, I'll follow the light off that bright new star.
We faithfully followed where the star led. Always its light crept just on ahead. It shone day and night, great deserts we crossed. Not even once did it get us lost. Finally over Judea it stopped. We found the door and trembling we knocked.
What are you doing? Why are you knocking? This isn't the place we're meant to be stopping.
I've led you so far, keep following on.
All right, I see now where you're going wrong. You think a palace is where you will see. The king that you seek, that's not where he'll be.
When King Herod heard about this, he was very upset, and so was everyone else in Jerusalem. He called together all the chief priests and the teachers of the law and asked them, "Where will the Messiah be born?" So Herod called the visitors from the east to a secret meeting and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem with these instructions: "Go and make a careful search for the child, and when you find him, let me know, so that I may too go and worship him."
This is the palace of Herod the Great. I see you've bought gifts for the pile by the gate. What do you mean that these aren't for us? For who else are you making such a big fuss? Wait, don't explain that where Herod can hear. He doesn't deal well with rivals, I fear.
Three kings come to visit. Isn't that nice? I am King Herod. Now take my advice. If you are looking for one greater than me, though really, I don't see how that could be, try Bethlehem. But if you find this Jew, tell me, so I can worship him too.
Well, that was awkward. So let's all agree to steer clear of him. He's far too creepy. Follow me onwards. Let's ditch this crowd and then prepare to be majorly wowed. This is where the great King of Kings. This is the place to make your offerings.
And so they left. And on their way, they saw the same star they had seen in the east. When they saw it, how happy they were, what joy was theirs. It went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. They went into the house, and when they saw the child with his mother Mary, they knelt down and worshipped him. They brought out their gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh, and presented them to him.
O son of David, my lord and my king, after much thought, it is gold that I bring. O ruler of all, to you here I bow, mighty one, master, God here with us now. Nothing is greater than what you deserve. Emmanuel, it is my privilege to serve.
O light of the world, God's chosen high priest, I carry frankincense from the far east. Good shepherd of all, please pray for your sheep. High Prince of Peace, your great power runs deep. You've come to us here to finish God's plan, bridging the gap, splitting heaven from land.
O Saviour divine, the one great I am, myrrh is my gift for anointing God's Lamb. Redeemer of all, our debts you will pay. To bring us to God, you are the true way. We know we can trust every promise God made. Thank you for being the price to be paid.
Stars in the bright sky.
Hi, it's Beth here. I'm going to lead us in today's prayers. Now, as you can see, I've got my lovely stable here with me. And if you have a nativity set at home, you can act out as well. I'm going to add the characters as we pray, and you could join in at home. If you don't have a nativity set, that's all right. You could do it with any play figures you have, any people, any Lego characters. They can join in too. Okay. And when I say Jesus Saviour, if you'd like to, you can reply, hear our prayer. Okay. Let us pray to Jesus, our Saviour. Christ, born in a stable, give courage to all who are homeless. Jesus, Saviour, hear our prayer. Christ, for whom the angels sang, give a song of the kingdom to all who weep. Jesus, Saviour, hear our prayer. Christ, who worshipped by the shepherds, give peace to all who are oppressed. Jesus, Saviour, hear our prayer. Christ, before whom the wise men knelt, give humility and wisdom to all who govern. Jesus, Saviour, hear our prayer. Christ, whose radiance filled a lowly manger, give the glory of your resurrection to all who rest in you. Jesus, Saviour, hear our prayer. Jesus, Saviour, child of Mary, you know us and you love us. You share our lives and you hear our prayers. Glory to you forever. Amen.
So we started our service in darkness, and those of you who noticed continuity errors will see that we are ending it in light. But of course, that is the message of Christmas, even in these dark and difficult times, that the light of Christ shines in the world, the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness cannot overcome it. Wherever you are this evening, on your own, with others, I pray that the light of Christ will bring you comfort, that you will know his love and his peace in this Christmas time. And so I pray that the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit will be with you and all those you love this day and always. Amen.
Stop.